Hey, what is up everyone? Norman from Future Student University here, and welcome to another video in our Retrofit series. In the last video, we have looked at basic authentication, so a standardized way on how you can identify your user to your server. In this video, we will look at a less standardized version of it, which is token authentication. So instead of encoding the username and password on every request and sending it with it, we are getting a special token. Most APIs create the token when you log in and then return it to you, and all subsequent calls are going to be made with that token. Basically, all protected endpoints expect that token as the authorization header. And in this video, we will look at how you can implement that on an Android app with Retrofit. Just like last time, before we jump in and implement it on Android, I will show you a tool, which is Postman, where we can emulate the requests and see what the server returns in what scenario. So here we have a login endpoint and we are sending data, so it's a post request. Unlike last time where we used the basic authorization, this time we're only sending a JSON object. So when we click here over body, we actually see how we can send a user and a password and send that over to the server. Now it's important that you do this on an HTTPS environment. Otherwise, this can be read by anyone and you shouldn't send passwords in clear text. Now in this case, the response is the user ID, the email, and also that secret token. And the token is important. You need to save that because you will need it for all following requests. So I'm going to copy this. Here we have a second endpoint, which is get secret info. And if you're sending this without any token, we will get a 401 back. So basically the server is telling us, hey, I won't give you that information unless I get a valid token from you. Most token APIs expect the token in the authorization header. So use the authorization as the header key, and the value will just be that special token we just got. So if we send it now, we will get an interesting string back. And once again, if we change this token to something that is invalid, so we send a token but it's not correct, we will get that error message back. So let's implement all of that, the login and then the get secret information on the Android app. I'm going to show you a lot of code in this unit. If you want to read it, you can find a link to the tutorial in the description below. It's the first thing. This is the app we're going to implement. I've already prepared the model classes. So the login class is when we are logging in and we have to send the user and the password. And the user model is what we're getting back from the server. So in this case, ID, email, and the token. So let's describe the Retrofit interface. So the first interface we need to describe is the login. So as you have seen in Postman, this is a post request and the URL is simply login. Now we expect a user object back. So this is going to be user and let's call this just simply login. Now as a request body will be the login class I have just showed you. And that should already be it. Now the second part is, let me make this a little nicer. And the second part is the secret info. So this is simply secret info. And as you have seen in Postman, it's a get request since we are just requesting data. Now, since it's just a string, we won't do any transformation into a Java class. And this will be get secret. In this request, we need to send the token with. So we're going to add an additional parameter, which is going to be header. And this will be a string. And it will be the auth token we want to send. And now we have to tell Retrofit that this token is going to be the authorization header. And if I can spell authorization, there you go. Okay, so first step is we're going to log in with the login information. That login gives us a user object back where we have the token. And then we will use that token to request the secret. And the secret is just a string, so we won't do any parsing. And we can display that to the user. So let's jump into the activity and implement all of that. I've already prepared the general retrofit stuff, and I've also already added the button listener. So if you go into our design, you will find we have a login button. We will simply hard code the login info, and then we have a second get secret key. So in our activity, when the login button is clicked, we want to make the login request. So let's create the login object. And that was the username, and that was the password. Next step would be creating the request call. So user client, so our interface we have just described, and now we're going to use the login method. You're going to pass the login object, and all of that will give us the call object. Now on that call object, we can call enq, and let's add a callback. Now, if something major went wrong, we will just show a little toast. And if we get a response from the server, we need to check if the response was successful. So maybe if the login didn't work, we would show a little error message. So if it's not successful, so the else case, you will simply show us our login not correct. And now when the login is successful, we will get that user object back. So let's take the response, and the body contains the user object, and on that user object we have the email, we have the token and the ID. Let's just show a toast with the token. And then what we also need to do, we need to save the token. So ideally, in your case, you might want to save it in shared preferences or a database. Since this is just an example, I simply have a string here. So I will just store it in that string. So the token is response body and get token. Then we have that token available to us. And for the get secret method, we can use that. So down here, the get secret is also on the user client, but it is the getSecret method. Now here we need to pass the token. So we have just stored it in the token string. So we pass it here when we call getSecret. Again, we have a call object. This is a separate request. And on that request, we can call enq again. We have the same callback, so let's just copy and paste this real quick. Of course, we can't display the token when we just got a secret, but we can simply display the body we get back. So let's just review. When we click the login button, we will create a new login object. We will send a request to the server with this object. The server will respond with the user class or user object. We will take that token from the user and store it up here. And then if we click the secret afterwards, we will take that token and access the secret from the server. And since this can throw an exception, we will also put a try catcher on it. So let's execute this and see what happens. Actually, let me change this to the login is not as a token. Not correct. And let's try this again. All right, here's our app. So if we click get secret, we don't have the token yet. So we would expect that we wouldn't get the secret. And it says token is not correct. So the server responds, hey, you're missing that token. So if we click login, here's that secret token. And if we click secret now, we will use a token to get that secret message. And that's it. So in this quick and simple example, you have seen how you can use the token authentication to log in the user, get the token, and use the token for further requests. Obviously, when the API gets more complex with more endpoints, This is still not ideal. You should save the token in a more central place, and ideally you also handle the authorization header in a more central place. One option is the server generator, which we will show you in a separate video in the future. So stay tuned for that. Thank you for watching. If you've learned something in this video, please give it a like and subscribe if you want to see more videos in this series. Enjoy coding and make it rock!